Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial Decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the lead editorial. Now today's lead editorial is written by Phulpur Balakrishna. Now from examination point of view, this is important for GS mains paper 2 plus. This is important for political science, public administration and sociology optional students. Now what is the core theme of today's lead editorial? Now it primarily deals with the behavior of electorate, the behavior of Indian electorate. Now this editorial that has been written, it has been written with respect to the recent poll result of the Gorakhpur seat and the Phulpur seat. Now on both these seats, it's the BJP government that have lost the elections, whereas the other party, that is the Samajwadi Party, has won these seats. Now Phulpur Balakrishnan, in order to understand what the election result of these two seats will mean for the future, that is primarily for 2019 Lok Sabha elections, in dono seats ka jo result aaya hai 2019 mein uska kya impact padega, this is the analysis that has been done. And like UPSC, it has begin to ask questions with respect to caste, रेस, रिलीजन. पहले एक ट्रेंड होता था, यूपीएससी इन सब चीज़ों को पूछता नहीं था, बट ऑफ लेट जो ट्रेंड है यूपीएससी का, वो अब इन क्वेश्चंस को भी पूछना यूपीएससी ने शुरू कर दिया है. एंड दिस इज द रीजन दैट वी मस्ट बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग द बिहेवियर ऑफ द इलेक्टोरेट, बिकॉज दैट विल गिव अस एन इनसाइट हाउ द फैक्टर्स ऑफ द कास्ट, रिलीजन, रेस, दे विल बी इम्पैक्टिंग द फोर्थकमिंग इलेक्शंस. Now according to Phulpur Balakrishnan, as far as the Indian electorate is concerned, it is no longer consuming the agenda of Hindi Hindutva or Hindustan. Rather, the electorate is getting mature. Apart from the dose of Hindutva, it is the electorate that actually wants economic development, economic prosperity, and above all that, the electorate is looking out for well-being, the overall well-being, the social and the economic well-being. Now the social and the economic well-being cannot be conferred solely by talking about the religious aspect or by the caste aspect. So these two seats, Gorakhpur and Phulpur seats, electorate primarily have exhibited this factor, that they cannot be carried away solely by the factor of religion. Rather, what they want is development. Now, another very important analysis that has been done by Phulpur Balakrishnan, it is about how the Indian electorate will be voting in 2019 and how this particular thing should actually decide about the tactics, the strategy of the Congress party. Now when it comes to the Congress party is projecting itself as a secular party. Now this is the antidote that the Congress party is offering to the intelligentsia that had been challenging the BJP government. जो बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट को बहुत लोग चैलेंज करता रहता है, लाइक द बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट सेकुलर इन नेचर, इट इज हिंदी, हिंदू एंड हिंदुस्तान, इट इज नॉट प्रो माइनॉरिटी, इट इज नॉट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ मुस्लिम्स, इट इज नॉट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ माइनॉरिटी रिलीजन्स. उस चीज को चैलेंज करके कांग्रेस पार्टी इज प्रोजेक्टिंग इटसेल्फ एज अ सेकुलर पार्टी. बट अकॉर्डिंग टू Phulpur Balakrishnan, जस्ट बाय प्रोजेक्टिंग इटसेल्फ एज द सेकुलर पार्टी, the Congress will not be able to win 2019 elections. Agar 2019 ka election jeetna hai, to secularism akela kaam nahi karega. Apart from secularism, Congress will have to project itself as if it is having some agenda for the economic prosperity. Because you cannot envelop the psyche of the entire nation just by talking religion, religion and religion, or just by talking caste, caste and caste. Because at the end of the day, the citizenry of India is actually looking for their personal welfare, their personal economic and social well-being. Now, this is the most important thing. The people are looking out for their prosperity. अगर आपको प्रॉस्पेरिटी देना है, वेलबींग देना है और इकोनॉमिक हाइटस जो गैप बन गया है अमीर क्लासों और गरीब क्लासेस के बीच में, अगर आपने उस हाइटस को कम करना है तो अकेला सेकुलरिज्म काम नहीं करेगा, उसके साथ साथ में कुछ इकोनॉमिक प्रोग्राम और इकोनॉमिक एजेंडा भी चाहिए. ओनली देन द कांग्रेस विल बी एबल टू फाइट 2019 लोकसभा इलेक्शन. ये एक राइट स्ट्रेटजी होगा कांग्रेस के लिए, अगर कांग्रेस इस चीज को समझने का कोशिश करेगा. बिकॉज अकेला सेक्युलरिज्म पे फोकस करना इज नॉट द राइट थिंग. नाउ अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट हैज बीन पुट फॉरवर्ड बाय पुलपुरे बालाकृष्णन इज अबाउट द एग्जांपल, द एप्लीकेशन पार्ट ऑफ दिस, कि ये चीज और कहां पे देखने को मिली है. वी हैव सीन द सिमिलर थिंग हैपनिंग इन रशिया विद पीपल हैड बिगिन टू सी the European countries, how they were getting prosper with respect to Russia. Russia sirf communism karta raha aur jitna bhi European countries tha unka economic status bahut acha hota gaya, logon ka well-being bahut acha hota gaya, unka prosperity bahut high ho gaya. But these things had remained behind, these things had lagged behind, these things were actually dissuaded by the communist आइडियोलॉजी. तो कम्युनिस्ट आइडियोलॉजी को मॉडिफाई किया गया रशिया में. तो आज का जो रशिया है वो ना पूरा कम्युनिस्ट है, इट इज कम्युनिस्ट प्लस कैपिटलिस्ट. एंड सिमिलरली वी ऑल्सो चाइना, चाइना इज ऑल्सो नॉट सोनली कम्युनिस्ट, इट इज पोलिटिकली कम्युनिस्ट बट इकोनॉमिकली इट इज अल्ट्रा कैपिटलिस्ट. सो इन अ सिमिलर मैनर the citizenry of India, it is looking out for economic well-being. Because if you compare India with other South Asian countries, if you compare India with China, or for that matter, if you compare even India with Bangladesh, there are numerous social parameters and indices on which India has not done well. One of the indices is how the Swachh Bharat program has not performed that well in India. But if you take the open defecation case of Bangladesh, 10 years ago, the open defecation was 42% in Bangladesh. But from 42%, it has come down to 1%. So it is a big win for Bangladesh. So India is actually looking out for social reformation, economic reformation, and that requires political reformation. But political ideology should not be tying itself only to the secular aspect or being non-secular aspect. The country is looking out for economic agenda and economic plan and economic policy. So this was all for the editorial Decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. Now if you are interested in joining the offline classes or you're interested in buying the online packages, you can WhatsApp me at 84594000, or you can also send an email at brainyias@gmail.com, and you can also download our application. Name of the application is IAS Buzz, and you can also practice answer writing on Magica software that we have designed, in which you can practice answer writing on real time basis. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.